in California, Washington State, Oregon, I'm not sure what other states, I know of those three, they have laws that if you're a therapist and you explore with someone who comes in saying that they believe that they're trans and you explore with them why they believe that, and you maybe encourage them to think about what are some underlying issues and perhaps to help them feel more comfortable in the body they were born in, that is considered a conversion therapy by these laws. They can, if the patient complains and says that you're trying to convert me out of being trans, you could get your license dinged. You could get into trouble. At least they could file a complaint and you'll be fighting for your professional livelihood. So that's what keeps people very silent. And that's what keeps people who are ethical just away from that population to do the ethical thing. So that there's that piece also. Because you don't need to be a gender specialist to work with gender. In fact, I encourage people who don't know very little about gender to work with people who struggle with gender, because it's not about gender. If you're a good therapist, you know how to work with someone and just explore with them what their issues are, and you help them figure out what's going on for them, because it's always it's a symptom of something else. Like you were describing a few scenarios. I have a whole chapter of like 25 plus reasons or influences why kids could believe they're trans. There's so many different sort of types or different kinds of people, different severity of, you know, how embedded they are in the ideology. Those who usually have early trauma or early attachment issues, they tend to have more early onset and more prevalent feelings of discomfort in their body. So oftentimes it has to do with trauma, but there are all different scenarios. There's the rapid onset gender dysphoria cohort, and those are the teens that have been online a lot that are really in this social contagion, which is not politically correct to say that it's a social contagion, but it's super obvious that it is. So I'm going to say it, even though it's not politically correct. So there's the boys that get caught up in too much porn, and then, you know, their whole like belief of sexuality is completely off kilter, and that gets them caught up in this. There's a lot of autistic kids get caught up in this. So their autism, they're being marketed to. They have their own autistic trans flag out there for them. They have several flags. I reference like the show Big Bang Theory from Sheldon Cooper. Like he's, you know, autistic character, and he has this whole fun with flags show. I don't know if people saw that, but it's like, that is exactly what the trans activists are doing, that you get your own flag, and, you know, autistic kids like that kind of stuff. So they're really being marketed to, and their temperament and their, you know, inability or struggling, their struggle socially, that, you know, that all plays a role in it, and they're the way they relate to the world, and they have very rigid thinking. So once they get caught up in that idea, it's hard to pull them out. So there's all these different underlying reasons, and they're not so, most of them are not so deep either. Some of them are even on the surface, and the gender therapist will even see it and know it, but they will ignore that part because they believe that if they alleviate the gender distress, then that will alleviate the other stuff. Although anybody with common sense would see it's the other way around. So.
And is that at this point, is that just how they've been manipulated? Or do you think in your experience, maybe based on conversations you've had with your colleagues and peers, are they choosing not to look at that because they fear repercussions, for example, under the conversion therapy laws? Or do they genuinely believe that because they've been brainwashed to believe that we don't need to look at that issue? Or, I mean, what do you think is right now today, April 16th, 2024, where do you feel like, what's the temperature in your community of professionals regarding this issue?
Yeah, I mean, I think my perspective is skewed because I'm, you know, on this end of things. So I'm meeting the people that agree with me more now at this point, because the people that disagree with me I'm not talking to them as much. They don't want to talk to me, right? So it's hard for me to get a real feel. So I just want to be honest about that. But my impression is, like, when I went to that conference last year, a lot of people just weren't aware of what was going on. They kind of make an assumption in their mind, like, that we are still exploring things with kids. They have no idea how harmful the cross-sex hormones are, and they don't realize how easily and accessible they are to young people, and how they're doing all this stuff without parental consent, and they don't realize how influential and how pervasive these messages are online and in Hollywood and everywhere. They just kind of don't think about it. So I think a lot of it is just not being aware of what's going on. And then the people that do, there definitely are a lot of people that really do believe it in, and I would call them brainwashed. I think most of them do have good intentions. They're being, mm-hmm. they believe that they're really saving these kids. So they get these rescue fantasies. So a lot mm-hmm. of therapists, these kind of therapists used to be weeded out. Me, like I told you, know, I was a supervisor. A lot of what I would do as a supervisor, and people did this with me when I was young, is we were checked, right? When we were young and we're like, I want to save this kid, or I over-identify with this kid. I feel, you know, that I want to take them home almost, you know, that feeling when you meet a kid that's struggling and you don't like their parents. I mean, every therapist goes through this. This is natural. You feel that rescue fantasy. But what we do as therapists is we check that and we say, but I can't rescue this kid. They have a family. All I can do is help them and give them what, you know, the best I can, but it's not my job to rescue them. So instead of that, they call that countertransference in the therapy world. We check our own feelings. They don't get in the way of what the person really needs, because it can cloud our vision of what a client needs. We try to be as, you know, unbiased as possible. But now with this, those type of therapists that fall into that feeling of wanting to rescue people are really gravitating towards this trans ideology, because they can really feel like they're a savior for these kids. They believe that their parents are evil or misguided, you know, horrible religious conservatives and yucky and something like that. And so most of the time, to be honest, these families, especially in California, they're not any of that type, but they just have it in their head that they are, because they don't even talk to the parents to even find out that turns out the parents were very liberal and went to the Pride parade 3 years in a row before. So they're not against any of this stuff. They just know that their kid is going through something, but the therapists just project that, and they think it's their job to rescue these kids. So they get caught up in that. And the trainings I went to reinforce those feelings, as opposed to saying, oh no, keep those feelings in check. That's not appropriate. You need to explore what's happening in the family. You need to connect with parents, even the parents you don't like, even parents whose values are different from yours. No, they don't learn any of that. They say, if you don't think the parents, and they go by a teenager's word. I mean, what freaking therapist goes by the word of a teenager who's having behavioral issues? All of a sudden it's like, we have to believe what they say. I don't know. I feel like their brains are fried a little bit, but they're being taught that, to keep those secrets, and it's their job to be their savior. So that's how they get brainwashed. It just reinforces those unhealthy, you know, feelings. The countertransference is the therapy word for it. Those feelings where you want to help, but you're not really helping